Hey, Harry Potter fans, Peter Kenneth here. Welcome back to the Potter Collector Channel, where we are a community of collectors. Today is day 4 of Wand Week, where we will be discussing the more darker side of wands. Really, only one of these wand owners is a villain, Lord Voldemort himself. But also in this video is the Elder Wand, Draco Malfoy, and Severus Snape. Now, the Elder Wand is included in this video because, one, Voldemort did acquire the wand, but all three of these characters have something to do with the Elder Wand. I will tell you more about that at the end of the video. And while they're not necessarily villains, Draco and Snape aren't exactly nice throughout the series, so we're gonna put them in this video as well. If you're new to the Potter Collector channel, welcome. We are happy to have you here. And to you Potter Collector community members, welcome back. Now, somewhere in this video, I will be sharing a letter, and that letter is one of 7 that are being shared throughout Wand Week. This is day 4. This is gonna be the 4th letter. If you collect all 7 letters and are able to spell out the secret word, you will be entered into a giveaway to win the exclusive Harry Potter store Golden Snitch wand. So keep watching because you never know when that letter is going to pop up. I think we should go youngest to oldest. So we're going to start with Draco. Here is his wand box. Now, these are all Noble Collection wands. The Noble Collection sells their wands in 3 different tiers. Their highest tier is this collectible wand box format. Then they have this more simple Ollivander looking box or a window box, which is really just retail packaging. It's a cardboard box with a window which shows the wand. It's meant to be recycled. Now, these, in my opinion, are the best to purchase. They're only a few dollars more. And they look absolutely fantastic and make you feel a little extra magical. Draco Malfoy's box is a Hufflepuff yellow. I wonder what Noble Collection is trying to tell us. On each end, we have a sticker with a symbol on it. Now, each Noble Collection wand comes with a little card, a certificate of authenticity, saying that it is an authentic Noble Collection item. And here's what I love about the Noble Collection collectible wand box. Just like the Ollivander wands in the movies, we have this cloth ribbon holding the wand. On the inside, it is lined with velvet to really protect your wand, keep it scratch-free. And here is Mr. Draco Malfoy's wand. Extremely simple. He has a black handle with just a little bit of detail that separates the handle from the wand shaft itself. And then the wand is a dark wood color. You can see some nice wood grain on here. Now, this isn't actually made out of wood. This is a resin material, but it is painted to look like wood. Now, Draco Malfoy's wand is made of hawthorn and has a unicorn tail hair core. Now, what I love about this wand is its simplicity. Now, we see a lot of wands that are very ornate and very different. For example, you'll see Lord Voldemort's wand looks like it was made from a bone, whereas Draco Malfoy's wand looks a little bit more how I imagined wands to look in the books themselves. So that's one of the things I love about Draco's wand, as well as the overall linear look. It looks like just one straight piece of wand, with, again, a little bit of detail here separating the handle from the wand itself. Next up, we have Mr. Severus Snape, and he is in a grayish-green box. And that's the other thing. All of the Noble Collection boxes are different colors, which is cool. So again, they look fantastic on your shelves. And we're going to peel the ribbon away to reveal Severus Snape's wand. Now, Snape's wand is also very, very simple. It is solid black. The handle is also very simple, but also ornate. It has some really cool carvings on here. It's in more of a square shape, which is a nice contrast to the rest of the wand. Now, when it comes to Snape's wand wood and core, it's unknown. We can only guess. And speaking of only being able to guess, the secret letter for today is E. E for Elder. E for evil. E for Voldemort, who we're talking about next. The Dark Lord himself, who has a black box, black like his soul, black ribbon, and it reveals a very unique wand indeed. Here is the wand I was telling you about, which looks like it was carved from bone. So the handle itself is bone. Voldemort's wand is made out of yew, and it has a phoenix tail feather core. Now, that is the same core as Harry Potter's wand. Both of the feathers came from the same phoenix. So much detail on this wand, and it just looks so dark. The wand handle itself almost looks like a bird, and then there's some really nice detail transitioning from the handle down the wand itself. It's a very cool, very powerful, very dark wand. At the end of the wand handle, there's a nice little pinky holder. It just feels great in your hand.
Abracadabra!
All right, last but not least is the Elder Wand. It comes in a really beautiful dark blue box. The ribbon is very shimmery. Aren't these boxes amazing? I just love these things. And then inside is the most powerful wand in existence, the Elder Wand, which is made of elder. And the core of the wand is hair from a Thestral. Now, this wand is most well known as being Dumbledore's wand. He had this up until he died, but then we found out later that Harry Potter was the true master of the wand. But the wand itself is very ancient looking because it is a very old wand. There are 6 different sized bulbs that go from the top of the wand all the way down to the handle. And then in between the wand handle and the wand itself, there's this white detail with ancient runes carvings. This wand here I would describe as like rough ornate or something along those lines. It's an ornate wand, but very rough and very organic, which I love and which makes sense based on the wand's history. Now, this wand was given to the first Peverell brother by Death himself, or so the story goes in The Tale of the Three Brothers, and it is quite a powerful wand. So you Harry Potter fans, what was your favorite of these 4 wands? Which of these wands would you choose to add to your collection? Leave a comment down below. For me, the Elder Wand is always going to have a special place in my heart because Dumbledore is my favorite character. Design-wise, it is also my favorite. So, the significance of the Elder Wand with these other 3 character wands. Before Dumbledore died, he was the true master of the Death Stick, or the Elder Wand. The Elder Wand changes allegiance if it is won by another wizard. It always has allegiance to the strongest wizard. Draco Malfoy disarmed Dumbledore before he died and became the master of the Elder Wand. Spoiler alert. Snape killed Dumbledore. We'll come back to that. Voldemort, knowing that Snape killed Dumbledore, not knowing that Draco disarmed Dumbledore before Snape killed him, thought that Snape was the true master of the Elder Wand. So in Voldemort's mind, in order to become the true master of the Elder Wand, he had to kill Snape, not knowing that Draco was the true master. But at the time of killing Snape, I know this is very confusing, read the Harry Potter books, Harry had actually become the true master of the Elder Wand because he had disarmed Malfoy. So anyway, that's why I wanted these 3 wands to be connected with the Elder Wand. There's a lot of history between the 4 of them and miscommunication. I will see you guys tomorrow for Wand Week Day 5. If you have any questions about Harry Potter or collecting, feel free to leave a comment down below. You can also join the Potter Collector community on Instagram at the Potter Collector or on Twitter at Potter Collector. Now it's time to like, comment, subscribe, and until next time, keep collecting. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, welcome. You can subscribe right up here. You can also look at some previously posted content down here. If you have any questions about Harry Potter books or collecting, please feel free to contact me. I'm always happy to help. But for now, I must go. See you next time.
Whoa, where'd he go?